SpaceX has just revealed its new plan to colonize Mars and make humanity a multi-planetary species. Overpopulation, climate change, and nuclear annihilation are just some of the major threats facing us Earthlings today. Elon Musk, the founder of SpaceX, believes that the best way to ensure the survival of our species is to spread out into the galaxy, with a colony on Mars being the first step. Let's take a closer look at this ambitious plan. Elon Musk states that the future of humanity is going to divide in one of two potential directions. Either we will become a multi-planetary, space-faring civilization, or we are going to be stuck on the Earth until an eventual extinction event that is either caused by nuclear war or natural disasters. He states that humanity's future is much safer when going with the first option, but a lot of that burden lies on the success of the rocket, which is responsible for taking humans to Mars. The initial plan needs a big spacecraft to work. This rocket is estimated to be at least 200 feet tall when fully assembled and is called the Falcon Heavy. The rocket will be attached to an interplanetary transport system aptly named the Starship and will be loaded on top of a 39-foot-wide booster, which will produce a massive 28 million pounds of thrust. Made up of no less than 42 individual Raptor engines, the booster will accelerate the Mars-bound craft to over 5,374 miles an hour. Overall, the entire craft is estimated to be 3.5 times more powerful than NASA's legendary Saturn V, which is the tallest rocket to date and carried the Apollo missions to the moon. Additionally, the Starship is planned to launch from Pad 39A and the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, Florida, the same pad which took humans to the moon and would perfectly symbolize our return to the stars. After the initial launch, the rocket is responsible for delivering the Starship crew capsule to orbit around the Earth. After it has done so, the booster will detach and steer itself towards a soft landing back at the launch pad. While this feat seemed almost impossible at first, SpaceX rockets have been doing it successfully for several years now. The next stage would involve the booster picking up a fuel tanker and carrying it into orbit as well. This fuel tanker will then be used to replenish the Starship for its voyage towards Mars. Once en route, the craft will deploy solar panels to harvest energy from the sun in an attempt to save precious onboard fuel for what will be an exciting and groundbreaking landing on the red planet. According to Musk's vision, these crafts and their crew will remain in Earth's orbit until a planetary alignment brings the Earth and Mars closer together. This is a window that opens once every 26 months. The long-term plan for SpaceX is to have many hundreds of spaceships waiting in orbit to depart en masse as part of the Mars Colonial Fleet. Perhaps the most important part for this entire plan to work is the reusability of the boosters. Musk's plan revolves around making sure that each spaceship is capable of being reused as much as possible. He states that there is no way to have a self-sustaining colony on Mars without reusability. It's a fundamental part of the plan. He also adds that if the wooden sailing ships from the old days were not reusable, the United States probably wouldn't have existed. SpaceX estimates that it'll be able to use each of its rocket boosters a whopping 1,000 times, each tanker 100 times, and each spaceship 12 times at least. The first missions are only estimated to carry around 100 people on each ship, but gradually that number is expected to increase to more than 200. According to these estimates, putting 1 million people on the surface of Mars could take anywhere from 40 to 100 years after the maiden voyage. The reusability of the rockets also means that once there, the crafts can then be used to return to Earth whenever needed. After a few uncrewed cargo supply missions have already landed on Mars, the human phase of colonization will be finally ready to begin. One of the biggest hurdles that stand in the way is the red planet's notoriously thin atmosphere. NASA had to be extra careful when landing their Curiosity rover on the planet, which weighed a mere 2,000 pounds and is a tiny fraction of the total payload that the manned missions will carry. This is one of the reasons why SpaceX continues to perfect its supersonic retro rocket technology so they can gradually enter the Martian atmosphere and lower a very heavy spacecraft onto the surface using this reusable method. That's not all, though. Entering the atmosphere is another problem that needs attention. The craft needs to withstand a heated entry to the planet and perform a propulsive landing while still being capable of refueling and going back to Earth to start over again. The first few journeys would probably just drop off supplies and set up a propellant depot on the planet so return trips are possible when needed. After the supply runs are complete, humans can finally make their way to Mars. The first crew will need to rely on digging beneath the surface and dredging up buried ice. This will be used as a water source which will eventually power the entire colony. When the essential crews consisting of scientists and engineers have finally set up, competition will start over the first few seats that can take willing individuals to the newly colonized planet. Before Starship can launch to Mars, it'll start off launching commercial satellites, followed by a crewed flight around the moon in 2023. Although SpaceX has not given a timeline for its first missions to Mars, Elon Musk has said that the first Mars base could be up and running in 2028. And while Musk shared some eye-catching artist illustrations depicting what he called Mars Base Alpha as an intricate network of buildings and infrastructure, SpaceX's plans for the Red Planet are not quite that extensive. For its very first Mars missions, SpaceX will land at least two uncrewed cargo ships on the Red Planet before sending any humans there. Those cargo missions would bring supplies, such as life support systems and power generators, that the first astronauts on Mars will need when they set up camp. The first uncrewed Mars missions will also be tasked with confirming the presence of natural resources that can provide fuel for future two-way missions to the Red Planet. SpaceX wants to use water ice from the planet's surface and carbon dioxide from the Martian atmosphere to refuel starships on Mars, enabling the rockets to return to Earth. After those first two cargo missions, SpaceX will launch two crewed missions alongside two additional cargo-only flights to begin setting up a propellant production plant. At that plant, water and carbon dioxide will be converted into liquid methane and liquid oxygen, which fuel the rocket's engines. So while SpaceX intends to set up a transportation system for humans and cargo traveling to the Red Planet, the company won't be building an entire Mars base on its own. Musk has laid out his vision to create a million-person colony on Mars, but to establish that colony, SpaceX will have to work together with NASA and the agency's international partners and other commercial space companies. Several companies have already begun designing concepts for Mars habitats and have proposed orbital outposts similar to NASA's Lunar Gateway, which could serve as a waypoint for Starship and reduce the amount of fuel needed for return trips to Earth. The first Martian city will open to regular people, not just scientists and researchers. People interested in moving to Mars could pay for their flight with a loan. Once there, people would be able to pay off the loan by working in anything from iron foundries to pizzerias. Musk declared at a 2016 conference that there would be labor shortages for a long time. It's an idea that arguably bears resemblance to 19th century American company towns, where employees lived in a city owned by their employer. Especially in the early days, Mars may not have many choices for local employment, and you'll need to pay off that loan for your flight. This city would be free to govern itself on its own terms, as indicated by the Starlink Internet Service terms and conditions released in October 2020. This appears to stand in contradiction to the 1967 Outer Space Treaty, which states that the launch origin country is responsible for subsequent space activities. David Anderman, who served as SpaceX's general counsel when the terms were released, suggests that the two documents may be set on a collision course. Musk estimated in 2019 that it would take around 1 million tons of cargo to build a self-sustaining city on Mars. Assuming it costs $100,000 per ton to send cargo to Mars with the upcoming Starship, that would put a Mars city's price at around $100 billion. At the high end, Musk estimates it could cost around $10 trillion. SpaceX may not stop with just one city, however. Paul Wooster, the principal Mars development engineer for SpaceX, said at the 21st Annual International Mars Society Convention in August 2022 that SpaceX could build multiple cities. The idea would be to expand out and start not just with an outpost, but grow into a larger base, not just like there are in Antarctica, but a village, then a town, which grows into a city, and then multiple cities on Mars. Musk claimed in 2019 that a return ticket could cost around $500,000 initially, dropping to $100,000 over time. Musk's goal in 2016 was to reach a ticket price of around the median price of a house in the United States. That would suggest people could sell their houses to move to Mars. In 2017, Musk outlined an aspirational plan to send two cargo ships to Mars as early as 2022. It would then send four ships at the next closest approach, two crewed ships and two cargo ships in 2024. However, in March 2022, Musk suggested that a more likely date for humanity to witness the first humans on Mars could perhaps be 2029. It's also possible, however, that Musk was referencing the moon landing that took place in 1969, making it around 60 years between the two feats. Mars and Earth are at their closest around once every 26 months. The distance between the two at this time reduces to around 33.9 million miles. As SpaceX has yet to host its first orbital flight with Starship, it seems unlikely that it will send the first cargo ships this year. As SpaceX adjusts its plans to a more realistic late 2020s deadline, it's perhaps more possible that Musk could indeed meet his goal. Recent reports have stated that NASA is interested in the Starship. However, the agency won't be fully committed to using it for its first human Mars missions until SpaceX has proven that the vehicle is ready for flight. NASA is also considering using its own space launch system, Mega Rocket, for Mars, but the development of that new rocket has faced years of delays. Starship itself is still in the design phase and is constantly updated with new designs. SpaceX has also begun testing a small Starship prototype called Starhopper. The last step of the plan is something that is reserved for a distant future, as the technology for such a feat simply does not exist yet. The end goal for SpaceX seems to be enabling human life on Mars by turning it into an Earth-like planet. Terraforming can be classified as a type of climate change, but is much faster and more deliberate than what is happening on Earth at the moment. The idea is that Mars can one day be transformed into a habitable world, complete with oceans and vegetation. The only thing in the way is the planet's ice caps, rich in carbon dioxide. It's uncertain if the terraforming of the planet can be done in a sustainable amount of time, and, according to NASA, it may not be possible at all due to a lack of gases trapped in the poles. If you like this video, you may also like this one, which talks about new evidence that may prove the existence of Planet X. Do you think SpaceX can build a Mars habitat by the end of this decade? Please share your thoughts in the comments section below.